Hello there. Welcome once again to CigarReviewTV.com. Today we're doing the Legendario from Camacho. It's in this really, it's in the, you know, little plastic of course, but it has a nice little seal going on it here. Very nice. So we will take this baby apart. Today is Sunday, March something. The 6th, I believe. Smells pretty nice so far. There's the actual look of the band. This is 100% Honduran cigar. It's made in Honduras. The wrapper, the filler, the binder, all from Honduras. It's got a little pretty thing at the end there. So, that's good. Let's take that off now. I don't think I want to smoke it with that. It might mess with the flavor. There's a NASCAR race just starting, so that's pretty cool. Into NASCAR. I'm not a diehard, but I enjoy it. Might watch a little bit of that after this. But I'm going to enjoy the cigar, the full cigar. And once again, there are people around where I do this, so every now and then you might hear a car start, which you're going to hear pretty soon. You'll hear a car door open, slam, all that crap, but you know. There we go. It is 1:19, so not quite wine time for me right now. It could be, but I don't really have a bottle open, so I'm just going to go with a quick cup of coffee with it. Not bad. Nice and hot, but beautiful day here in Arizona. Right now it is literally 75 maybe. It's supposed to be really close to 80 today. Later on this week it's going to be in the 80s. So, it happens out here. I love it. And the light. This ring gauge is another giant one, so it should give me a lot of flavor. I've never gone for a really big ring gauge before. It's never been something that I really wanted or had to have. This is actually a 60 ring gauge. I had a cigar, I believe it was one of the Alec Bradley ones back a few reviews ago. It was 58, and that was one of the bigger ones I had ever smoked. This one, the biggest. It's 6 inches long, and the ring gauge is 60. Very small hint of pepper, but other than that, so far right at the beginning, very aromatic. I love that about, you know, if you don't smoke cigars, then you might actually really hate the smell of a cigar. If you've never been around them, you don't smoke them, a cigar might be something you actually hate. But if you smoke them, obviously, if you've ever been around them, the smell of a cigar can be just really nice. Either bring back memories, good, bad, who knows. Hopefully good. This, nice scent for a cigar. Really nice. These are made by Camacho, who also make they make another cigar that I actually haven't seen around for a while, at least in the humidor that I go to. But it's a Baccarat cigar, and it's got little, you know, playing cards on it. It looks fairly cheap, you know. But I always really enjoyed it. It was just a real cheap little smoke. It's usually like $3.75, something like that. They're probably in the $4 range nowadays, but it's a Robusto size. A little sweetness to it. Always enjoyed them. And that's who makes these. No sweetness going on here. So far, smoking really nice. The burn line, if you can see it. Sometimes the lighting, I don't have professional lighting, so sometimes the lighting isn't great for it, but the burn line, well, like if there's a real heavy blackness right in there, that'll kind of tell you as far as that the aging process was kind of rushed. This is very thin, not dark at all. So far, the way it's looking, looks like it's going to hold the ash really well. For me, a lot of the taste of cigars, as I've said before, have a lot of nut flavor, a lot of, there's an actual bug out here, actual cedar, wood, those kind of flavors. Very obviously, it comes from the ground. It's leaves, they're just a bunch of rolled leaves. So it's gonna have those type of flavors for me. The more punchy cigars, the ones that are really smack you hard, that actually burn kind of in there, real peppery. Those ones, you know, that's the only other kind of characteristic that I find a lot. Like I said before, there's a lot of people that'll sit there and say, well, this one has a pencil lead to it, or this one's got, you know, some rubber, or for me, I never get those kind of things, and not sure what they've been chewing on, but sorry. Went with a nice little cup today, nothing huge. It's not early in the morning, so I don't need my massive Starbucks cup. Usually bring a cup out here that I don't care that much about, in case it breaks. So more than likely, most cups that you'll see on here will be ones I don't care about. If I talk about a cup a lot or something that I really love, then you'll know it. The draw on the cigar is very nice. Again, I'm getting really lucky. All these different cigar makers are doing a very good job, or I'm getting very lucky on all the picks that I've been doing. This has been just been getting great draw cigars. Nothing, I can usually, like, if there's going to be a cigar that's extremely hard to draw, it's usually going to be very, very hard. Like, if you just kind of, you don't want to really squeeze a cigar, you don't want to break it open and stuff, but you can kind of tell by the feel. Very nice. Very nice. Very good draw. Spring is in the air here in Arizona, and I know it's March. Spring is coming close for everybody else too. April is when stuff starts going here, early March. And I just love the beautiful weather, always have. Very big fan, so. The birds, just everything, you know. Love it. I'm going to start picking some places. I'm going to go to a couple resorts, find some little places that are just beautiful, and kind of hang out and do a cigar review there. Different places other than the porch. Porch works. It does a good job. But, you know, a little different scenery would be good. You'll have to excuse me every now and then. I don't look right at where the camera is, which is right there. Hello. Sometimes I end up veering away and looking at kind of the monitor part of it, so sorry. Hopefully it doesn't look like I'm ignoring you. A lot of you might be watching this on YouTube, and if you are, that's very cool. Pretty big fan of YouTube. I look at a lot of stuff there. You can usually find a lot of videos that, you know, you're kind of looking for on there. It's such a cool medium to find. But you could also, if you want, you could go to Sakar. Okay, had a mild stroke apparently right there. CigarReviewTV.com. That's my website. You can leave comments. Looking in, possibly putting a forum in there, but I'm not a huge fan of forums usually, honestly. I get lost on where a link is and what a thread is, where it all goes. So I'm a pretty big fan of Twitter, so you can follow me on Twitter if you want. CigarReviewTV. That's where I am on Twitter. Or also just Damon Pettit, that's also me on Twitter as well. But as far as cigars go, Cigar Review TV, and then CigarReviewTV.com. There, plugged myself like 1,000 times in 2 seconds, it's great. You didn't probably see this, but as I just did that, a ring came out of over there. I don't usually do smoke rings, but every now and then one flows out. It's just kind of cool. Still very, very smooth, elegant smoke. Elegant might be not the right word, but definitely a fine cigar going on right here. This is the Bertha cigar, I guess. You know, they'll name the different blends, the different cigar that they have, either by size or whatever, double Corona, margarita. They should really do that, margarita blend. This is the Bertha. And I know in the golfing world, the Big Bertha is a big one. This definitely is quite the thick. Look at that. It's huge. So, it's like a tree. I'm smoking a tree right here. Again, so you can see the actual label. You want to look for it. Again, I get this at my favorite cigar store out here in Arizona. It's the one I go to the most. And so that one is the Ambassador cigar right out here. 2 miles away from where I am. I've walked there a few times. The laws and everywhere is different as far as smoking, but here you cannot smoke at all at the restaurant, you know, outside even on the patio you can't smoke. I'm pretty sure you can. And definitely on the inside, no smoking, period, they don't have. So I think possibly on the outside you can. But, you know, like a cigar store, they can have a permit or whatever to so you can smoke in there. So they have nice area where you can sit down, talk to everybody. They have their cigar club, which you can go back into their little special area. And, you know, it's really, really kind of a fun environment if you're a cigar connoisseur at all. Again, I'm looking into ratings and stuff like that, because I know a lot of people go by, oh, this was rated 90 in Cigar Insider or Cigar Aficionado or Cigar Magazine. So I'm looking into that, seeing if I want to delve into the ratings at all, do my own rating at all. So far, I'll just tell you how much I like it, and then if I know a cigar has been rated a certain, you know, high thing, and Cigar Aficionado, all those carry a little bit of weight, so I'll let you know if I know that, and then that way you know, you'll have that little bit of information too. I'm getting some comments here and there. Very much love comments, because that's the only way I'll know if you're watching. It's the only way I know if there's a problem with what I'm doing, or if I could improve it, or if it's perfect, whatever it might be. I like to know. Also, if you're looking at this on YouTube, you could rate, which is cool. I like the little thumbs up. Got one thumbs down, and I was actually surprised that I didn't get more. That was on my second review where I tried to live stream it and screwed it all up, so I won't be doing that anymore. If I do, I'll have a backup source to where it's actual video like this that works out. Let's get interactive. Let's tell each other, what's your favorite cigar experience? I would really like to know. I love, like, there used to be, and I don't know if there still is, I thumb through the Cigar Aficionado here and there. I get it. But there's some places where it'll kind of just have a little blurb of one of their favorite cigar times or something. And I just really enjoy reading that because it's just kind of like, ah, it's a cool little story. And so, you know, is there a time where you went and grabbed a cigar and just had a fantastic, fantastic time? I'd like to know. Really would. Hopefully me tasting the cigar isn't a horrific look. Really don't care, I guess, because that's how I have to do it. I have to taste it. It's definitely, you know, I got that cigar flavor right there in the middle of my tongue still. It stays there, but it's not like extra strong, so it's kind of nice. You know, obviously, with pretty much any cigar you smoke, you're going to have that cigar aftertaste, and that's just how it is. But sometimes some are a lot worse than others. This one's pretty nice. Not too bad. I'm liking it. I would definitely give this, if you want to go 5 stars, I would go with the 4-star so far with this cigar. Still burning really well. The ash is definitely holding. You can see that. Pretty nice there. I like it. Almost running into 20 minutes on this one. I'll try to, let me just think of, I'll think of one cigar experience here. I've got a few people that I'll smoke cigars with, my family, and well, another one that's pretty much my family is Dr. Vince Yoder. Him and I were out in Pennsylvania. He was graduating college. He got his master's, I believe, when he was out there. He's now a doctor, and he'll be operating on me later. Just joking. Not that kind of doctor. Anyway, our first little good experience was we went and grabbed a cigar. He paid, of course, at a, seemed like any time, especially back in the day when we went out to do something like that, he'd grab it, you know. Anyway, we ended up getting an Ashton and some Maduro. Just took this really long walk by his uncle's place. It just rained outside. It was very beautiful. It was very beautiful because out there in Pennsylvania, certain parts definitely very green. And it was at that point just like that. It was that, you know, kind of that first cigar experience. Surprised by the intense flavor of a cigar. We're really surprised at the intense aftertaste. I do remember that we didn't, you know, there was still some left, so, you know, I kind of let it burn out. And I thought I'll save it, you know, so I stuck it back in the bag, put put in my suitcase. Woke up the next morning, I still had that taste in my mouth. I'm like, wow, that's pretty incredible. Opened up my suitcase. Oh my God. That was a learning experience. You don't want to save a cigar for later if you're just going to put it in a little plastic bag and put it in your suitcase. Wrong decision. It just was really strong smell. I had took a little bit to get that out of there, but the cigar smoking and hanging out with him in the first place at that time, that was just great. Had a good time. Look forward to doing that more with you, Doc. And looking forward to smoking some cigars with my papa-san and family. So, anyway, wherever you are and whatever you're doing, I hope you're really enjoying yourself. I hope you are enjoying the reviews. I really enjoy doing them. So, it's just, you know, it's just fun. So, again, this one, the Legendario. Is that what it is? Yeah, Legendario. Make sure I got that right, you know. From Camacho. Very nice, I'd have to say, on a scale, 4 cigars out of 5. Very nice, very nice. And the only reason why I go to 4 is just flavor intensity. It's very flavorful, but, you know, I've had a couple of others that are really different kind of flavor, really nice. But everybody's different, everybody's scale is going to be different. So just take that for what it's worth. Yeah. Maybe if you're gonna go golfing, this is like $6.90, I believe. So I mean, very affordable, not bad at all. Go give it a try. Feel free to please leave me any comments. Go to CigarReviewTV.com. That's where I reside, and I run my website, so it's gonna keep continuing to improve. It's very new, so. It looks a little bare maybe, but it'll keep getting better. Take care of yourself. I look forward to my next review with you. And any input's greatly appreciated. You have a fantastic day, night, morning, whatever it is. And thank you very much for watching. I mean, extra really big thank you. Because, you know, I'd just be talking to myself. Instead, I get to talk to you. You take care, and I look forward to seeing you in a day or so. Bye-bye.